the senior health official said that the ministry urges everyone to get rid of all mosquito breeding sites in their homes, yards and workplaces by securely covering or turning over any containers holding water, placing fine mesh over vents of septic tanks and clearing gutters and spoutings. Mr. DeShong says the ministry will continue to keep the public updated on Zika in SPG and anticipates continuing partnering with the people of SPG to maintain our health. The Vincentian Students Association of Jamaica, Vinsa JA, is inviting new students as well as prospective students wishing to study in Jamaica to its new students' orientation on Thursday, 11th August at 4:30 p.m. at the University of the West Indies Open Campus here. President of the association, Tanisha Baptiste, said the orientation will brief students of the essentials of living in Jamaica and provide assistance for new students wishing to register with the University of the West Indies Mona Campus for the upcoming semester. She added that the main sponsors of the association will be recognized at this year's event. According to the Searchlight newspaper, a student of the Bethel High School died in intensive care on Thursday, July 28, shortly after surgery. 15-year-old Justin Young underwent emergency surgery at the Milton Cato Memorial Hospital following a mishap in Choppins. The vehicle in which the lad was traveling went over an embankment on the Choppins public road. The lad suffered from a fractured skull, a damaged kidney and internal bleeding. The Belvedere Neighborhood Watch hosted a lecture on pre- and post-emancipation in St. Vincent and the Grenadines SPG last evening at the Huffles Ranch. The lecture featured presentations by historians Curtis King and the seaman Alexander Hamilton. The overall focus was on how the Methodist Church helped to shape members of the Brighton Belvedere community in the early days. Mrs. Alexander Hamilton's presentation concentrated on the late George Hamilton Charles, leader of the first political party of SPG, 8th Army, how he stirred the political consciousness of Vincentians and his links to the Methodist Church. She also presented on the late Sir Fred Phillip, the first black governor of St. Kitts, Anguilla, and the late Reverend Fitz Allen John's contribution to the Methodist Church. Meanwhile, Mr. King looked at the Brighton Belvedere community security before emancipation. Telecommunications giant Digicel, last Friday, July 29th, launched its back-to-school component of its Bring the Beat summer campaign. The Bring the Beat campaign, which is currently being held in other digital markets across the region, was conceptualized to show Caribbean unity, specifically to celebrate all Caribbean athletes competing in Rio this year. The Bring the Beat campaign features five major components: prepaid and postpaid offers, text to win, scratch and win, social media competitions, and the Back to School promotion. The Back to School promotion, which got underway last Friday, allows customers to receive a brand new digital backpack with every purchase or specially priced smartphone on selected days of every week up until August 31st, 2016. The Association of Caribbean Media Workers, ACM, has noted with concern continuing efforts by some countries of the Caribbean to address legitimate issues associated with the harmful online content through legislation which, in our view, tramples on important principles associated with freedom of expression and freedom of the press. Some of our international partners, including the International Press Institute, IPI, Reporters Without Borders, RSF, and the Center for Law and Democracy, CLD, have recently addressed in fair detail offending sections of the cybercrime bill in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. We endorse their positions on such matters. These issues have also attracted the attention of other institutions with specialization in this area and have undertaken to keep them informed. The Vincentian Students Association of Cahill will host their annual summer lecture on Thursday, August 11, 2016. Professor Leonard Ogaro will present on the topic, New Industries for St. Vincent and the Grenadines, Upgrading Biodiversity, Assets for Economic Development. The lecture takes place at the French's House from 5:30 p.m. The executive of the Vincentian Students Association extended an invitation to the public to attend this event. Up next, the sporting highlights.